السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ ربنا واجعلنا مسلمين لك ومن ذريتنا أمة مسلمة لك وأرنا مناسكنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم ربنا وابعث فيهم رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياتك ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة ويزكيهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. Translation of the verses 128 and 130 from Surah Al-Baqarah. In the name of Allah, the Gracious, the Merciful. And remember the time when Abraham and Ishmael raised the foundations of the house, praying, Our Lord, accept this from us. For thou art all-hearing, all-knowing. Our Lord, make us submissive to thee, and make of our offspring a people submissive for thee, and show us our ways of worship, and turn to us with mercy. For thou art oft-returning with compassion and merciful. And our Lord, raise up among them a messenger from among themselves, who may recite to them thy signs, and teach them the book, and wisdom, and may purify them. Surely thou art the mighty, the wise.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Most beloved Zuraqtas, respected guests, members of Nottingham Jamaat, Assalamu Alaikum wa Rahmatullahi wa Barakatuhu. Huzur, in the early years, Jamaat was very small, consisting only of four families. But since 2001, Nottingham Jamaat has rapidly grown to a total of 186 members at present. Initially, members offered Salat and Friday prayers at the President's home. Then in 2001, members started to hire rooms at a nearby Bakersfield Community Center. And with the growing numbers, Nottingham Jamaat actively started looking for a suitable property for Nottingham Mosque. Last year, on the 26th of May, this property was acquired at a cost of £360,000. And the Nottingham Mosque is on the site of St. Bernadette's School, which opened in 1930 and closed in 1985. The mosque building itself dates to 1960. For the last 30 years, it was a Catholic church. Since May 2017, members have been using this mosque for the 5 daily prayers and other activities. Murabbiya Sinsla Fakhr Ahmed Aftab Sahib was appointed in September 2017 as the first missionary for Nottingham. Actually, Nottingham Jamaat organize well-attended interfaith conferences and have a very successful mosque open day in February. Hazur, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Nasir Khan Sahib and his team and Irfan Qureshi Sahib and the local Jamaat and region who worked very actively for a very short period of time last 2 months to get this into the shape we find it today. May Allah bless them all. We feel very humbled and blessed by the presence of Hazur Aqdas at this occasion. We pray that may Allah accept the sacrifices of Nottingham Jamaat members and enable them to fulfill their mosque with worshippers, and the local community also benefit from this mosque. May this mosque become a source of blessing for the local Jamaat. Ameen. Hazur, the construction cost of this mosque is £135,000. Total site area is 0.5 acres, and the cover area is 732 square meters. The capacity of the mosque itself is for 220 people, and we, inshallah, once we have planning permission, it is our intention to build a 3-bedroom flat for our Murabbiya Sinsla. So that's a brief report of this project. I would now request Hazur Aqdas to come and address us, please.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين Alhamdulillah, Allah the Almighty has blessed you with this new mosque in which you can join together to worship Him and also hold various activities and functions, which will inshallah be a means of tarbiyat for you and your children. Upon attaining this huge blessing, you should all be extremely grateful to Allah the Almighty. It is not enough just to verbally express your appreciation. Rather, true gratitude requires you to constantly strive to fulfill the conditions of path as prescribed by Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam and to act upon all that he taught and desired from his Jamaat. Above all, the Prophet Messiah alayhi salam wanted for us to seek the nearness of Allah, the Almighty, and to fulfill the rights of mankind. In relation to fulfilling the rights of Allah, always pay close attention to the following words of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam. As Masih alayhi salam said, offer prayers regularly and with due diligence. Some people offer only one namaz each day, but they should remember that the obligatory prayers are never excused by Allah. So much so that not even the prophets were excused. It is narrated in a hadith that a new community approached the Holy Prophet seeking to be excused from prayers. Upon this, the Holy Prophet said that a religion that does not require a practical element has no value whatsoever. Therefore, as Masih alayhi salam says, therefore pay special attention to this and always act according to the instructions of Allah, the Almighty. As Masih alayhi salatu wasalam further stated, always remember that forsaking Allah, the Almighty, and merely relying on human efforts is foolishness. You should bring about such a spiritual revolution in your lives that it appears as if you have been bestowed with a new life. Also, you should make istighfar your constant companion or a feature of your life. On another occasion, Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi wasalam warned his Jamaat that people were prone to neglect the rights of Allah due to their worldly affairs. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi wasalam said, those who lack time because they are consumed by worldly pursuits should be the most fearful. Those people who have worldly jobs are often negligent in fulfilling their obligations owed to God. For this reason, in a state of necessity, it is permissible to combine the Zuhr and Asr prayers, as well as the Maghrib and Isha prayers. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam further said, inappropriate excuses for forsaking namaz are nothing except a result of the weakness of one's own conscience. He says, do not be guilty of negligence and injustice in the fulfillment of the rights of Allah and the rights of mankind. Be honest and manifest integrity in the fulfillment of your religious obligations. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam has also guided us in great detail about how to treat one another. He desired for Ahmadi Muslims to be sincere companion, compassionate, and loving people who deeply cared about the feelings of one another. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam said, Allah the Almighty cares not for anyone except his righteous servants. adopt brotherhood and love amongst yourselves. Leave entirely all forms of hatefulness and conflict. Forsake all forms of mockery and taunting because they take a person's heart away from truthfulness and far beyond. Treat one another with respect, and every person should prioritize the comfort of his brother above his own comfort. Sincerely devote yourselves to Allah, the Almighty, and return to His obedience. We should also pay great heed to the following words of the Prophet Musa alayhi salam, in which he has urged his followers to devote themselves to Allah the Almighty. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam says, "The wrath of Allah the Almighty is descending upon the earth, and only those people will be safeguarded who sincerely repent for all their sins and bow down before Him." Today, the situation of the world is extremely grave and is becoming increasingly dangerous by the day. And so, to be saved from the devastating consequences of the wars and injustices prevalent in the world, we must follow the guidance of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam at all times. May Allah enable all of you to fulfill the rights of this mosque and to manifest the true teachings of Islam at all times. May Allah the Almighty enable the members of the Jamaat to remove the misconceptions about Islam that exist in society and bring people towards their Creator. May Allah the Almighty bless the local Jamaat members and enable all of you to be loyal and sincere servants of Ahmadiyyat. Ameen. Baz yahan log aur khas taur par lajna ki membraat mein se baz ko sahi tarah shayad english mein samajh na aati ho unke liye khulasa bayan kar dun. Pehli baat to ye ki yahan jamaat jo hai ab taqreeban meri malumat ke mutabik aadhi jamaat unki hai jo asylum seekers hain. Unke bacche to English padh rahe hain, schoolon mein ja rahe hain, lekin badon ko bhi jinme zuban ki kami hai is mulk mein rehne ke liye unko bhi zuban seekhni chahiye, apni zuban ko behtar karna chahiye taaki tabligh ke liye bhi usko istemal kar sake. Aur isi tarah bachchon ki tarbiyat ke liye bhi istemal kar sake. Maa baap ko agar pata na ho ki bacche kya padh rahe hain aur kya dekh rahe hain to bachchon ki tarbiyat bhi kharab hoti hai. Isliye apne ilm ko bhi saath saath badhane ki koshish kare wo jinke ilm mein deeni ilm mein bhi kami hai aur dunyavi ilm mein bhi. Khaas taur par lajna membraat is baat ka khayal rakhein کہ انہوں نے بچوں کی تربیت کرنی ہے اور جب تک اطفال میں ہیں بچے ناصرات میں ہیں بچیاں خاص طور پر ان کی ذمہ داری بنتی ہے اور اطفال سے عمر کے جو بڑے بچے ہوتے ہیں اس وقت پھر باپوں کی ذمہ داری بھی ہو جاتی ہے لیکن اگر بچپن میں صحیح تربیت ہو جائے تو پھر صحیح رنگ میں ایک اہم دی بچے کی اٹھان ہوتی ہے اور وہ ہمیشہ جماعت سے بھی اٹیچ رہتا ہے اور اللہ تعالیٰ کا بھی حق ادا کرنے والا ہوتا ہے اس تعلیم پر عمل کرنے والا ہوتا ہے جو حضرت مسیح علیہ السلام نے ہمیں دی اور جس مقصد کے لیے آپ آئے تھے. بس جن کو زبان میں جن کے یہاں کی مقامی جو انگلش زبان ہے اس میں کسی بھی قسم کی کمزوری ہے کمی ہے وہ بہتر کرنے کی کوشش کریں اور اس مقصد مسجد کے حق اسی وقت ادا ہوں گے جب آپ لوگ اپنے بچوں کی صحیح تربیت کرنے والے ہوں گے اور اگلی نسل بھی اللہ تعالیٰ کا حق ادا کرتے ہوئے اس مسجد کو آباد کرنے والی ہوگی اور اسی طرح لوگوں کے حق ادا کرنے والی ہوگی اور اسلام اور احمدیت کے پیغام دنیا میں پہنچانے والی ہوگی. اللہ تعالیٰ آپ کو اس کی توفیق دے اور آئندہ نسلیں بھی اس اپنے مقصد کو حاصل کرنے والی ہوں اور پورا کرنے والی ہوں. اب دعا کر لیں. آمین. I mean.